To pretty much get like 140 European shows under our hat, you know, by the time we finished December 14th. And that was something that when we started the tour, we hadn't planned, but it just became something that we wanted to do once we you know, had made it to Europe. And we wanted to really just like plant the seeds of Freaks, you know, like into the ground. And we did, you know. And we figured that once we had done that, it almost felt like we'd done a world tour. You know, I mean, we ended up playing England about like 4 or 5 times in Germany, 50 shows in Germany, you know. We actually were like ready to do some new songs. I mean, we've played the songs and the record so many times already. And we really, you know, spending a lot of time on the road, and, you know, we were writing some songs. And so basically we came home and took like a little break and then, you know, started writing for the next record. The second record, you know, we really took our time on the road. If ever there was like 3 or 4 days off, we went straight into like a club or rehearsal studio and started writing, because there was this sort of hunger on the road. We were living on a bus, we were freezing, we were hungry. The money we were getting out of there barely made it to McDonald's. And that sort of really gives you a certain sort of attitude, especially, you know, coming from America where it's a little easier to live. Everything is basically around the corner and it's open 24 hours a day. But there we really felt it, and I think you can really hear it in the songs. Basically all the subjects, you know, lyrical wise, and so I'm very dark and very, you know, in many ways depressed or angry with many things. Not that these things happened, it just, you know, started that sort of feeling, you know.
In, you know, thinking about what the next record was going to be all about and stuff, we thought, man, you know, we've got all these people that follow us, you know, that it's like a family, you know. After you play like, you know, 40, 50 shows in England, you start to know people and stuff, you know. And it's like, you know, Mike came up with the concept Gathering of Freaks, you know. And it really is, you know. And the words that he came up were brilliant, because he's talking about, you know, feelings that everybody has, doubts about themselves and stuff like that, and that it's okay, you know. And it's like everybody feels that, and that's, to me, that's a big highlight in the concept of the record, is within the words and everything, is that we're gathering, you know, people together that really want to just, you know, let their feelings go and show, you know, like, be humans, you know. It's not about, you know, egos and stuff like that. It's all about, you know, people letting those feelings go, and that's, to me, is the highlight of this record. And hopefully people will get that, you know, through a song that's about drug abuse, or through a song that's about, you know, violence and gunning people down, you know.
About Freak of Nature from the start, when I started the band, was that I wanted democracy, and democracy is like the hardest thing to get, and get five people to agree on the same thing. But this feeling of really that we all compromise amongst ourselves to really make everybody be happy, you know. It's like, you know, I mean, just even when it comes to the mixing of the record, can everybody be happy with that the kick drum is this loud and the guitar is here? We go through that every single day, and we really put an enormous part of really a lot of talking in. It's something that we didn't have in the bands we were in before, and I think it's the only way we can survive. It is so hard out there to be in a rock band today and wanting to have a record out and tour and just even, you know, put some food on the table. I mean, it's not like the 80s where millions of dollars were flying around. The biggest, most well-known producer could not have done anything to this record that we couldn't do, because what's on that record is the way we want to do. I mean, if we wanted anything, it was maybe just an extra week, so we wouldn't have to really, really rush. There's a good side and a bad side about the 90s, how music have changed, but it just really allows people to be more real and not super big productions. And I think that's where maybe the producers now are seen more than the band, because now a record's not going to be judged if the snare drum is not like big sound like Def Leppard created in the 80s, and everybody was in there spending days hammering through drums and trying to get that sound. Now it's like 2 minutes for the drum sound, and then let's go for the vibe. Emotions under lock and key, first and dying to be. One song called The Tree on the record that within the band has a special meaning, and it will be later to be explained. It's something that just happened, but it's just something we feel very good about. It's like a song we took to different dimensions, you know, something that we maybe thought we couldn't write, and it came really, really easy. We basically wrote it, finished the song like in one day. You know, where other songs maybe, you know, like, okay, this guy needs to take homework home, you know, like, we need a little guitar part here, so, you know, make that home before we can go on. But The Tree, which lyrically deals with the story, I mean, it's a song about clear-cutting, you know, I mean, the environmental of the forest, but it's explained from the tree's side. With this tree, it's being turned into the electrical chair, and at the same time reversing, you know, the side of, you know, of killing someone. And it was an idea I had, you know, I had the idea lyrically, and I told it to the band, and I think that Jerry came up with this, started this bass riff, and right away I think everybody knew what the song was going to be about as we were writing it. The whole feeling of this, I mean, it almost could be like a mini movie because of the subject, and I just saw this whole thing, and we were talking about it, and we just started jamming, and this whole vibe came in, and it was basically the way it was written the first day is the way it just remained, and it's a song I think is going to be, you know, really interesting to play.
I'm not afraid.
album's coming out the third week of September in Europe, and we will be starting a European tour probably in the first week of October, about 2 weeks after the album is released. Will be a concentrated tour that will take us to every single country. And it's something that, as we said on the first record, regardless if we have to play for 20 people in Oslo, which we did, probably because it was a summer vacation. But, you know, we still are going to do it because we don't know if this is going to work. We have said to ourselves that we want to play everywhere again, you know. We can't play as many shows as we did last time, but, you know, this time it'll just be a more concentrated thing. But we want to cover every country, which we did last time. I think the only Western European country we didn't do was Greece. But we managed to play everywhere, and we will do that again. And it's basically something that we cannot wait to get on the road again, regardless of knowing how hard it is, because we're basically going to do it the same way as we did last time.